गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ प्रोफेसर धवलचंद राणा एंड वी विल स्टार्ट अ यूनिट नंबर 5 नॉन एज इंट्रोडक्शंस ऑफ साइबर क्राइम इन्वेस्टिगेशन। एज पर आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर कंप्लीटेड अवर यूनिट नंबर 4 ऑफ साइबर सिक्योरिटी सब्जेक्ट। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस सम पॉइंट्स रिगार्डिंग अ साइबर क्राइम इन्वेस्टिगेशन विच आर पार्ट ऑफ अ यूनिट नंबर 4। We will start a basic concept about introductions to cybercrime investigations, keyloggers and spyware. In this particular topic, we will focus on what are the different cybercrimes and how they are investigate these particular crimes with the help of different technologies. Then we will discuss some point regarding a keyloggers, what is keyloggers, what are the different types of keyloggers and how hackers will access our system through these keyloggers as well as a spyware. Later on in this unit, we will discuss some of the points known as virus and worms, trojans and backdoors, steganography, DOS and DDoS attack, SQL injections, buffer overflow and attack on wireless network. So all the points we will discuss in unit number 5 of cyber security subject. Today we will start off this unit with reference of introductions of cybercrime investigation. So guys, we will start with the cybercrime investigation. First we will discuss what is a cybercrime, what are the different things which is cover on a cybercrime. Cybercrime is an criminal activities that involve a computer, network, devices or a network. As previously we would know that what is a cybercrime, whenever we perform some activity or we can say illegal activity with help of any of the electronic device as well as a network or we can say internet, the concept should be covered on a cybercrime. So when we discuss a cybercrime, we know that we are using two different components on a basic prior note known as a computer as well as a internet. While most cyber crimes are carried out in order to generate profit for the criminals or we can say cyber criminals, because they are a pure professional technical person who can earn some money with a cyber crimes. Some cyber crimes are carried out against the computer or a device directly to damage or disable them. Like what are the different activities should be part of cybercrime? Some hacker did the cybercrime for the disable or damage our personal data as well as our personal computer. While some other uses computer or a network to spread a malware, it is one of the kind of viruses through they can access our data as well as access our system whenever they want to. As well as some cybercrime, it should be illegal informations without any kind of permissions they can access our personal data. It is also the cybercrime as well as image or other materials, because we are storing some of the data in form of images, video, audio file and lots of things which we are covering through this cybercrime. So whenever some unauthorized person can access our data which are part of our personal computer and with help of some digital technologies through which they can access our data without any kind of permission, it is known as a cybercrime. And what they are wanted to be, they are just accessing our data, they can damage our computer system as well as they can perform some spreading viruses through which they can access our informations, network informations and all the things through which they can gain some profit. So it is known as a basic fundamental things in form of cybercrime. Some cybercrimes do both the target computers to infect them with a computer viruses. As previously we discussed, they can spread a malware. The same thing means they are targeting some computer to infect them with a computer viruses. So if they are penetrate one of the viruses in any single system, so they are accessing all the data which are part of throughout the network, and those who are accessing this particular system which are affected by the viruses, so they can spread within the complete network. So they are just targeting one system and spreading viruses without any kind of permissions, which is then spread to other machines and sometimes entire the network. As we discussed, if some targeted machine is easily accessed through the internet and if they are successing to penetrate inserted viruses in any of the system, so they can easily getting all the informations through which they are connected and through the getting all the entire network, because one computer system spreading viruses all over the system and all over the network. Now he says, a primary effect of cybercrime is a financial. As we discussed, they are gaining some profit through this technology. Cybercrime can include many different types of profit-driven criminal activities, including ransomware attacks. Nowadays, it is the most prior thing which we need to learn to know what is a ransomware, how it spread, and how we denied some those kind of activity which should be part of a ransomware, because it is the most prior attacks nowadays in a cybercrime. Whenever some ransomware happen in our system, they are just gaining all the data with some encrypted algorithm, as well as they can encrypt over all the data, and whenever we wanted to open this particular file, it should be never be open it, or it should be in unreadable form. So when we want to read this document, and if we want to this convert encryption to decryption, means unreadable form to a readable form, we want to pay some money, and it is the main thing which should be part of a financial activity. Email and internet fraud, we know very well what is a phishing, how the phishing it should be happen. And identity frauds, means we believe that we are doing something, but behalf on us, they are doing something which is not illegal activities. So it is known as identity frauds. As well as attempt to settle a financial account, credit card or other payments card information. We read lots of news regarding the online activity which should be part of cybercrime, like a credit card frauds, debit card frauds, and all the thing which should be really at a prior positions nowadays, because we are using a lots of data within the internet. Nowadays we are performing lots of activity through the internet, like paying a money, transferring a money, done recharge through the different applications, and all the thing like a financial lots of activity we are doing with the help of internet. Cyber criminals may also target an individual's private informations as well as corporate data for the theft and resales, because if some criminals, or we can say hackers, they can target some individual computer, they are not gaining so many data which should be only take a personal informations. But if they are performing, or we can say targeting some organization's computer, so they can getting so many informations which is part of organizations, like patents, projects, lots of information through which they can gaining more and more profit, and they can sell it those kind of data with a competitive company. So they are targeting only those peoples who are part of organizations as well as some big giant company, so they can gaining more and more profit. Now a cyber crimes investigation. If some criminals hack our system, then how they are find out that what are the activities should be happen in this particular system, how they are hack our system, what are the different part through these particular data or particular system should be accessing. So first we know that what is a cybercrime investigation. A cybercrime investigation is the process of investigating, analyzing and recovering critical forensic digital data from the networks involved in the attacks. Means all the thing through which attack is happened and what are the different activity should be done throughout the attacks, what are the different data should be damaged, what are the data they can access it without permissions, and how they access or how they gain access of our personal computer. It is a part of a investigation. This could be the internet or the local network. In order to identify the authors of the digital crimes and their true intentions, because if we analyze, investigate and recovering critical forensics digital data from the attacks, so we can easily identify that what is the actual intentions to access, or we can say illegally access, our system of a hacker. Cybercrime investigator must be an expert in a computer science, because all the thing it should be part of a computer data, understanding not only the software, file system and operating system, but also how a network and a hardware works. Means if we some want to join the cybercrime investigation, you must be know that the different thing which should be part of cybercrime, like a software, file system, operating system, as well as how a network should be work. Hardware is also a most important thing to investigate some of the cybercrime, because the actual thing which should be find out through this hardware, or we can say scan some basic concept regarding the particular crimes. So if you want to build a career on a cybercrime, or we can say a cybercrime investigator, then you know that all the thing which should be covered with the cybercrime investigations. There must be knowledge enough to determine how the interactions between these components occurs to get a full pictures what happened, why it's happened, when it happened, who performed the cybercrime itself, and how a victim can be protect themselves in a future against this type of cyber threats. This is the most important thing to define that what is a cybercrime investigation and what are the different duties if you are become a cybercrime investigator. They are just going to interpret or analyze that what happened, means what is the different techniques through which they can access our data. Why it's happened, what is the main intentions about this particular thing, when it's happened, it is the most important thing, a durations about the activity which should be illegal ones, who perform the cybercrime itself, means who can perform this activity. Because if you know about all the things, then it is easy to identify that who is a criminal and what they are doing it. So it is the actual things through which a cybercrime investigation justify your cybercrime. Who conduct a cybercrime investigations? Means what, who are the authorized person through a cybercrime investigator? Criminal justice agencies. Like a criminal justice agency are the operations behind the criminal preventions, campaigning and the investigations monitoring and prosecutors of a digital criminals. Depending on your country of a residences, a criminal justice agency will handle all the cases related of cybercrime. Like if some accident or murder happen in our particular city, we are going to a police stations through which the all the activity should be registered and they are finding some criminals. Same thing, if some activity should be done on a cybercrime, there are some police stations like a criminal justice agency through which we can register our complaints and they are find out all the thing which should be we are covering in our previous slides. Means they are actually find out all the things regarding a cybercrime which should be happen with us. Second, for example, in a US, as a depending on the case, a cybercrime can be investigated by the FBI. I think you know very well all the English movie, rest of all this case which should be covered by the FBI. US Secret Services, it is also perform a cybercrime investigations. Internet Crime Complaint Centers, as well as US Postal Inspection Services or the Federal Trade Commission. All the mentions part, it is of the US country through they can investigate a cybercrime. In other countries such as Spain, the National Police and the Civil Guard take care of the entire process. So, no matter what type of crime is being investigated, because if some crime it should be happen with the general public or some big organization, they are just going to this particular agency through which they can investigate his or her personal cybercrime. Second thing, a national security agency, it is also the most important role nowadays in a cybercrime. What they are doing, this also changes from one country to another, but it in general. This type of agency usually investigate a cybercrime directly related to agency, because they are a national security agencies. Means all the country they can perform any kind of local agency, there must be reports all the cybercrime activity through these national security agencies. For example, an intelligence agency should be in charge of investigation cybercrimes that have some connections to their organization, such as against its network, employees of data, or have been performed by illegal actors, like who are the actual hackers through which they can access our data. In the US, another good example is a military which run its own cybercrime investigations by using the trained internal staff instead of recycling on the federal agency. As an example shows that, as a previously we discussed, the investigator is the most trained person through they can investigate a cybercrime. And what are the different topics? They are remember that they are knowing about the hardware, file system, operating system, as well as about the network through which a cybercrime it should be happen. So in a US, a good example of cybercrime, it is known as a military. Means they are a trained person for a particular war as well as against the cybercrime. They are the basic trained person. They have some technology used through which they can identify a particular crimes, as well as they are knowing about how the crime it should be happen, when a cybercrime it should be happen, and what are the intentions behind this particular crime it should be happen. Third thing, it is known as a private security agency. It is a non-government agencies through which a private security agency are also the important in the fight against a cybercrime, especially during the investigation process. Because while the governments and a national agency run their own the network, servers and the applications, they make up only a small fractions of the immense infrastructures and code kept running by the private companies, projects, organizations and individuals around the world. This company works for only those kind of big giant company where they can access regular basis, because lots of company have a daily affected some criminal activity through the cybercrime. So those private agency always believe that if they guard some big giant company, so they are safe all the data which should be kept with the particular database within this giant organizations. They have also kept a security against a government data. If some of the data is leaked by the government, then some big disadvantage of the data as well as misuse of this particular informations, because government have lots of data of a particular company as well as the basic peoples who are gain particular countries. So they are the gaining some data, or we can say protect some informations of all the organizations who are part of a big giant on a particular nations. With this in mind, it's a no surprise that a private cybersecurity expert, research companies and blue teams play a critical role when it comes to preventing, monitoring, mitigating and investigations any type of cybersecurity crimes against the network, because those are the informations through which private agency perform the denials of all the cyber crimes, and system or a data running on the third party private data centers, because some organization they have its personal server and some company then purchasing server of a third party. So all the data it's not be stored within this company, they are storing up data with some remote server, so through which a private security agency watch these particular activities, who can access the particular data, what amount of data should be requested, what kind of data should be requested, and how many times a particular data should be accepted. So all the activity should be monitoring by the private security agency, and if they found some unauthorized or illegal activity within this particular data, they can directly inform the particular organization, as well as they are protecting all the data which should be against the illegal accesses. So those are a private security agency through which we can investigators who can investigate a cyber crime. Now we study a cyber crime investigator techniques. What are the different techniques they are using to find out the particular cyber crimes? Now we see, while the techniques may vary depends on the type of cyber crime, because it is the most important case what type of crime it should be happened. If we know that the particular cyber crime it should be happened, then the different technique is basically available. So while a technique may be depends on the types of cyber crime being investigated, as well who is running on the investigation, most digital crimes are subjected to some common technique used during the investigations. So now we study what are the different common techniques through which a cyber crime investigator investigate a particular crimes. First one, it is known as a background check. What is a background check? Creating and defining the backgrounds of the crime with known facts with help investigator set a starting point to establish what they are facing and how much informations they have when handling the initial cyber crimes report. Because who are investigating this particular cyber crime, they generate some report after completions of all the investigation through which they can submit this report on a particular jurisdictions. On behalf of us, they are just presenting report and they are gaining some attentions against of this particular cyber crime. So background check is just the basic concept through which they can find out that how the actual path is happened and what are the different techniques through which investigators set a starting point, as well as establish what they are facing. Means what are the different difficulty faced by the hackers who can access our illegal system. Second thing, it is known as a digital forensics. Once a researchers have collect the enough data about the cyber crimes, it's time to examine the digital systems that were affected or those supposed to be investigated on a particular cyber crime to be involved in the origin of the attacks. Means in a digital forensic, after investigating all the cyber crime, they getting two most important in concept about a system were affected and who are the involved person, or we can say hacker, they can access our data. Third, this process involve analyze a network connections raw data, hard drive, file system, caching devices, RAM memory and more, through which they can scan all the data, they can find out that what are the data is damaged, what the data did be affected through the viruses and what are the data it should be gaining the access without any kind of permissions. Once the forensic works start, the involved research will follow up on all the involved trailed, looking for the fingerprints in a system files. Network and service logs, emails, web browsing history and all the things. Because if they're gaining all the informations regarding a files, network, service log as well as email and web browsing, so they can easily find out that how the criminal access our data and through which they can access our data. So first we block the gate, or we can say a backdoors, which hackers will be used to gaining this particular accesses. Third thing, it is known as a tracking and identifying the authors. This next steps is sometimes performed during the information gathering process, depending on how much information is already in hand, because it is the current situations, or we can say runtime situations on every nodes. All the criminal activity is different techniques. So based on the current situations, they are gaining some information against the hackers, so can easily find out the identifying authors. In order to identify the criminals behind the cyber attacks, both private and public security agency often work with the ISP, or we can say internet service provider, and a networking companies to get the valuable log file about that connections as well as historical services, websites and protocol used during this time and they were connected. In short, we can say that if we gain all the informations regarding the particular crime with help of ISP, so can easily identify that who are doing this particular crime and who are the actual persons, they can access our data without any kind of permissions. So it is the informations regarding how a cybercrime investigator use a different techniques during the cybercrime investigations. Now last technique, we will discuss the cybercrime investigations technique, through which we can identify that what are the techniques it should be happened within the cyber criminals. Informations gathering, I think you know very well what is the informations gathering, how it's helpful to identify the hackers, hacker techniques, how we reback the particular data through which they can access our informations, what are the different algorithms they are using. So we can easily identify that if some information should be happened within this particular data, and if we found that this particular algorithm is used within this particular techniques, so we can easily recover our data through a information gathering. So it is the one of the most important concept about the cybercrime investigations. Once the most important thing any cybersecurity researcher must do is grab as much information as possible about that incidents, because if we know that all the crash level informations, or we can say zero level informations, then we can easily find out that what is the cybercrime and where a cybercrime it should be happen, what is the importance, what are the different part they are using, what they are gaining our informations, and how their particular data will be accessed through the particular informations, what are the different techniques they are using, how they gain access with the particular data, if they are using some data, then what they are doing now, and how we denied if some attack should be performed on a later on. What is an automated attack or a human based target criminals? Was there any open opportunity for the attack to happen? What is the scope and impact? Can this attack to be performed by anyone or by certain peoples with the specific skill? Who are the potential suspects? What digital crimes were committed? Where can be evidence be found? And do we have access such evidence sources? As previously, we will discuss all the questions. If we answer of all the questions, then we can easily find out that depends on this particular questions, we can easily get that all the data regarding a cyber crime, and it is the main importance duty of a cyber investigators. So guys, it is the things which we will discuss on a starting note of unit number 5 of cyber crime investigators. If you know, or if you want to interested about this kind of job, then you know about what is the actual duty and what are the different questions we need to answer on a base on whenever cybercrime it should be happen. And these and other questions are the valuable considerations during the information gathering process. So it is the last technique which we are used by the cybercrime investigations. Now we see one video. It is the basic informations about how a cybercrime happened and what are the investigations things which should be happen in a cybercrime activity. So guys, I think it should be is useful information through which you can gaining about a cybercrime investigation. Now we see one video. Enough for today, and I hope you are enjoy this particular videos and gain some informations against the cybercrime investigations, as well as they are using different technology where if they are investing some a cybercrime. I hope you are enjoy this particular lectures. Thank you so much.